welcome to Space with Sarah. I often get asked what dark matter is and why we think it exists. Normally when we say matter, we're referring to the elements in the periodic table, which is what, for example, you, me, planets, and stars are made of. We are visible matter, also called baryonic matter, that interacts with light in the sense that we reflect light, absorb light, and emit light. For example, humans emit light in the infrared due to our body temperature, which is not visible to the human eye, which is why if you wear infrared goggles, you can see us in the dark. Dark matter, on the other hand, is something we can't see. But one piece of evidence that it does exist is from its gravitational influence on visible matter. If we look at a spiral galaxy, we can estimate how fast it should rotate based on how much matter it contains. For example, the velocity of the planet's rotation around the Sun is determined by their distance from the Sun and the mass contained within the planet's orbits. Similarly, we can estimate how fast stars should be moving around a galaxy. In the solar system, the planet's rotational velocities are entirely determined by the Sun, since the Sun is a lot more massive than any of the planets in the solar system. However, a star's motion in a galaxy will be determined by everything within its orbit, meaning all the stars, all the gas, planets, black holes that might exist in that galaxy. From Newton's law of gravity, we know that the rotational velocity of an object increases depending on the amount of mass within its orbit, and the rotational velocity slows down as the radius of its orbit gets bigger, as shown in this equation. This is exactly what we find for the solar system. When we do the same analysis on spiral galaxies, we don't see the same trend. The stars and gas are rotating a lot faster than they should be based on the amount of matter we can see in the galaxy. Even accounting for the mass from all the planets, dust, gas, and stars in the galaxies, the rotation is still way too fast. The natural conclusion is that there's some invisible matter accounting for the extra gravitational pull. We call this dark matter. Observationally, there are several other clues that dark matter exists, such as the velocity of galaxies moving around each other in galaxy groups, and also from gravitational lensing, where the path of light is seemingly bent by the presence of dark matter. All the existing evidence indicates that the matter we consist of, baryonic matter, is only a fraction of the total amount of matter in the universe, and that there's roughly 5 times more dark matter than normal matter. Astrophysicists still don't know what dark matter is. Some have proposed that it could be free-floating black holes or a fundamental particle we haven't detected yet. The nature of dark matter is still unknown and remains one of the big open questions about our universe. Hopefully, this will be resolved within our lifetime. Thanks for watching Space with Sarah. If you're still curious about the universe, please subscribe to the channel. And as always, keep wondering.